Abdur Rahkman leads Wolverines past Dolphins 76-51. Ann Arbor, Michigan, App. Muhammad Ali Abdur Rahkman scored 20 points and Michigan extended its winning streak to a season-high 5 games with a 76-51 victory over Jacksonville on Saturday. Charles Matthews added 18 points, Duncan Robinson scored 12 and Jordan Poole netted 10 points for the Wolverines, 12-3. J.D. Notae paced the Dolphins, 5-10, with 22 points, while Jay Hinton scored 11. A slow start by the Wolverines enabled the Dolphins to stay with Michigan early in the game. The Wolverines were up 11-7 with 10:52 to play in the first half when they put together a 15-2 run to take control of the game. Michigan led 32-18 at intermission, as Jacksonville shot just 26%, 8 of 31. From the field in the first half. The Wolverines began their win streak with a 78-69 overtime decision over UCLA on December 9. Victories at Texas and over Detroit Mercy and Alabama A&M followed prior to the Christmas break. The Dolphins have lost 4 of their last 5 games. Big picture Jacksonville, the Dolphins are 0-7 on the road this season. Jacksonville's Tony Jacek and Michigan's John Bailen are the only coaches in the nation over the last 7 years to improve their win total in 3 successive seasons on 2 different occasions. Jacek is a native of Whitehall, Michigan. Redshirt freshman forward Damian Sears was a high school football teammate of Dallas Cowboys quarterback Doc Prescott in Houghton, La. Michigan. Junior forward Mo Wagner returned to the Wolverines' starting lineup after missing 2 games with a bone bruise in his foot, scoring 5 points and pulling down 6 rebounds. Sophomore John Tesk averaged 11 points and 7 rebounds per game while filling in for Wagner. Matthews' 31-point effort against Alabama A&M in Michigan's previous game made the junior forward the first Wolverine to score 30 points in a game since Aubrey Dawkins scored 31 against Rutgers on March 7, 2014. Up next, Jacksonville, plays host to Trinity Baptist College on Tuesday. Michigan, resumes Big Ten play with a game at Iowa on Tuesday.